let's start the F-16 in the new cockpit. Virtual reality quest 3 passthrough with Openkneeboard. And a ramp start at Bordeaux Air Base in Kola DCS 2.9. Let's see if we can still do it. So verify checks. Throttle is in place, switches have been checked, we are ready to start. Right, so main power to battery. Test. Good lights. Power to main. Fuel is norm. Master norm for the lights. Anti-collision off. Steady. Lights checked. The air source is norm. And the GFS comes alive. Right, waiting for the GFS light. GFS light on, RPM is increasing. We wait for 25%. 25% and we advance the throttle. RPM increases, FTIT increases. At 50%, we look for a GFS light off and a switch off. Gorgeous comes alive, RPM is stabilizing, FTIT peaked and checked, and we have hydraulics at 12 o'clock here too. Gorgeous, check. Gear, tree green, we have a good start. Right, EPU check, no need. Avionics power, so let's power up the avionics switches here. So FCC, SMS, MFD, UFC, and all these three switches, and we start. The INS alignment, we cross check that it started. Good, then sensor panel, left aft point, right aft point, FCR, and radar altimeter to standby. The HUD is good, seat is good. Yeah, master caution, we still have the seat not armed, but that's okay. And IFF panel, so IFF panel to norm. And yep, we check we have mode 4. And we can load the DTC. So DTC load, that's the weather button. That's it. As the DTC is loading, we will check the flight controls. Check and launch the Flixbit. Flixbit is running. So as the Flixbit is running, we can check the flight controls. Normally we have a crew chief for that, but I'll check that myself. So yes, we see flight controls moving. Yep, okay, we're good on the Flixbit, so we'll wait for the results. Yep, Flixbit off, no lights, so the bit passed. We're good. Now DBU, so DBU check lights, we check flight controls again, check normal response, and DBU off and DBU light on. Trim checks, nothing we do special, just checking that these needles here are centered and the yaw is centered as well. That's the case. Air fuel check we cannot do because there is a bug in DCS. The sec check, it's the same, we cannot do it, and then we power up the avionics, so threat warning, aux on, and then ECM jamming pod RWR on. Program set to one, mode set to manual, and we activate chaff and flaw as we have 60. The TWP is good. Audio, we got COM1, COM2. COM1, COM1 is set, COM2 is set. ILS we don't need, the Taken is 45 X-ray for Bodo, and that's the audio that we hear. DD, UFC, MFD is so set, and we can check the... the gimmicks works good enough, so we can turn it off. Okay, next page, fuel quantity. So at this time in norm here we have just under 12,000 pounds, so we go reserve. We should have approximately 500 on each side. We go internal wing, external wings, so that means we have bags. External center, we don't have an external center, so show zero. Back to norm. Yep, so we get to ensure that we have here the bingo warning. Check on the INS. Okay. Right, so EPU fuel is, yep, full. Anti-ice we don't do, O-box we don't do, MPO, well, MPO is kind of difficult to do as a single pilot without crew chief. So basically what happens is that I should move the stick, check the controls, but it's way too difficult to do, so usually that's done with a wingman. Much easier. If you don't have a crew chief, ask your wingman. Speed brake, so I'll check the indicator. It's currently closed here, so I'll open the speed brake. I see that the indicator works fine. Alright, so now I'll close it back. Wait for the closed indication. Yep. We're good here. So we can... gauge the SRI, standby attitude, whatever. We can set QNH, which is 3003 for Bordeaux elevation on the QNH. We set the Mach index for 300 knots for departure. Check, good visual cue. And the pneu, there is a problem. It's the wrong one, which is encoded. So this will be needed to be fixed. And then we increase brightness on the EHSI because this one also defaults to very, very dim. So we have to increase the brightness there. Right, the flags on the EHSI is because the INS is still aligning. Good. What else? Going back to the checklists. Speed brake, so we can go to the next page. Okay, that's before taxi, so we have to wait for the INS to be ready. One caution light here. That's because we don't want to harm the seat as long as we are inside the hangar. So we'll do that later on. I still also need to close the canopy, which I know normally you should do before GFS, but anyway. What else? All seems to be good on the right side. On the left side, all seems to be perfectly good as well. So almost there on the INS. Right, we're ready to go. The align is flashing in the HUD. Ready is flashing in the dead, so we can move the switch to nav, and flags on the EHSI disappeared and ready stopped flashing, so we are good, aligned on the INS and ready to go. So let's close the canopy before we are ready to taxi. So canopy is clear, clear. Okay, so closing the canopy. Yep, canopy is closed. Closing the spider and the light comes off. Right, so before taxi, external light is set to steady. Check. Drift CO is set. INS is ready. INS EG switch is in nav, QNH is set, and cross-checked, ground crew we don't need them, ATC we don't need them, and alpha check, only do that in multiplayer, so no need here. So taxi, the taxi light is on, nose wheel steering is on, the seat is armed, nope, it's not, but it's on purpose, and we can move out of the hangar. We are clear to the right, we're clear to the left, so we don't have jocks. Let's move forward a little bit. Okay, testing the brakes as soon as I'm out here. Okay, testing brakes. All right, good. Yep. Right, that's it, gents. Looks like still works pretty good. Few details to work out. And here is my wingman here on the right coming to join me on this flight. So I'll see you guys later for hopefully soon new videos.